It is nearly midnight on September 28th, 1959. The night is dark and clear, and the sea is calm. Captain Rutherford is carefully navigating his ship, the SS Stanvac Bangkok, through a fleet of fishing vessels. As he and his officer carefully watch the seas, they notice whitecaps forming, despite the wind remaining calm. Soon, they are mystified by a strange sight. Huge, parallel beams of light begin to pass beneath their ship, stretching out to the horizon. As their boat continues on, it becomes clear that the beams of light were rotating around a central point, miles away, akin to the beams of a lighthouse. As the lights fade, two more spirals take its place, the beams of their light rotating beneath the calm waves, like the spokes of two massive aquatic wheels. As Rutherford continues to navigate past the smaller fishing boats around his ship, these wheels of light appear to follow him, keeping pace with the Bangkok, as if chasing it. Soon they fade, leaving behind a multitude of flashing lights, glistening circles all around the ship, that blinked in and out, before finally letting the Bangkok return to the darkness of the night. This was just one example from a long history of strange sightings in the North Arabian Sea. They are known as light wheels, phosphorescent wheels, or the wheels of Poseidon, and sightings date as far back as 1879. Sometimes they are huge, sweeping spirals of parallel bands of light that seem to shine up from beneath the ocean surface, stretching out towards the horizon. Other sightings simply report long bands of light stretching from horizon to horizon, moving beneath the waves, or switching on and off in a regular pattern. Some sightings were preceded by balls of light that rose from deep within the ocean, bursting with a flash at the surface. Some wheels featured perfectly straight beams, while others curved and curled. There have been thousands of sightings like these from across the world starting in the 1800s, slowly declining towards the end of the 1900s. The Marine Observer, a quarterly publication that collected sightings and weather reports at sea, had collected over 2,200 sightings of ocean phosphorescence in only a 10-year span, as reported in 1931. The majority of these sightings seem to be located in the northern section of the Arabian Sea, an area known for being shallow and seismically active. It should be noted that the area most known for light wheels is also a heavily trafficked shipping route, so some sampling bias is likely present. That being said, it's not the only popular route in the ocean, and there's nothing special about this part of the ocean, but something about this part of the world, and only this part of the world, seems to be creating thousands of these strange sightings. Let's look at a letter from R.E. Harris, commander of the SS Shah Hejan. At 10 p.m., we were streaming along very comfortably. There was a perfect calm. The water was without a ripple upon it, the sky was cloudless, and, there being no moon, the stars shone brightly. The atmosphere was beautifully clear, and the night was one of great quietude. I went on deck, and at once observed a streak of white matter on the horizon, bearing south-southwest. In a few minutes, it had assumed the shape of a segment of a circle, measuring about 45 degrees in length, and several degrees in altitude about its center. At this time, it shone with a peculiar but beautiful milky whiteness, and resembled the nebula sometimes seen in the heavens. We were steaming southward, and as the bank of light extended, one of its arms crossed our path. The whole thing appeared so foreign to anything I had ever seen, and so wonderful, that I stopped the ship just on its outskirts, so that I might try to form a true and just conception of what it really was. By this time, all the officers and engineers had assembled on deck to witness the scene, and were all equally astonished and interested. Some little time before the first body of light reached the ship, I was enabled, with my night glasses, to resolve in a measure of what appeared, to the unassisted eye, a huge mass of nebulous matter. I distinctly saw spaces between what again appeared to be waves of light of great luster. These came rolling on with ever-increasing rapidity till they reached the ship, and in a short time, the ship was completely surrounded by one great body of undulating light, which soon extended to the horizon on all sides. And as wave succeeded wave in rapid succession, one of the most grand and brilliant, yet solemn spectacles that one could ever think of was here witnessed. If the sea could be converted into a huge mirror, and thousands of powerful electric lights were made to throw their rays across it, it would convey no adequate idea of this strange yet grand phenomenon. Here's a report from Captain Carlson of the Dover in 1908. This report, unusually, actually comes from the Gulf of Mexico. "I have sailed the high seas for 20 years, and have seen interesting phenomena, both meteorological and otherwise, in the waters of every known ocean, but I never saw anything that approached this blue and green light from the water. The night was dark, but clear, and we ran into the streaks without any seeming warning. It was so light that it was remarked by the chief engineer that it could be read by, and to make sure I grabbed a paper, and the finest print that I could find was easily discernible. We ran out of the streak into a streak of black water, and the darkness of the night seemed to increase as we did." Any scientific theory about phenomena like this has to be highly speculative in nature, because these occurrences are intrinsically difficult to film or photograph. It was only in 2019 that scientists were finally able to photograph the Milky Sea phenomenon, a phosphorescent event in which huge swaths of the ocean appear to faintly glow, described by sailors as like sailing on snow. Plankton are widely assumed to be the source of the actual light itself, and are indicated in articles as far back as 1931. Stijn Nous, who wrote a thesis paper studying light wheels for the University of Utrecht, suggests Noctiluca scintillans to be the specific culprit, a dinoflagellate known to exist in the Indian Ocean. Of course, there are other, less scientific ideas regarding the source of light that I'll talk about later, but most serious study involves plankton like the Noctiluca. The question thus becomes, what in the world could cause fields of microscopic organisms to flicker and glow in such particular patterns? Nous, in his paper, An Analysis of Marine Light Patterns, suggests several possibilities. Noctiluca is known to react to changes in water pressure, reacting by lighting up with bioluminescence. Thus, it's reasoned that the movement of aquatic currents, or pressure waves, could trigger them en masse. Since the North Indian Ocean is known for its underwater earthquakes, it could be that waves of pressure from the ocean floor could cascade upwards and stimulate the plankton, with the particular spiral banding patterns possibly being caused by math. The science here is beyond me, as I'm really nothing more than a sentient toaster. But although this seemed like a potential explanation of some of the light wheels, Nous wasn't at all satisfied in calling this a solution to the whole phenomenon. Magnetic fields are also suggested as a culprit. Some strange interaction between the Earth's magnetic field and the iron hull of older ships could create patterns of electromagnetic waves through the water. This could track well with the stories that tell of the light wheels following ships, along with other stories of oceanic lights, such as a 1959 incident in which colored rays of light were seen emanating from the stern of a ship, accompanied by other aquatic flashes of light that seemed to be caused by the ship's movements. Nous went on to perform an experiment wherein Noctiluca scintillans were stimulated, first by acoustic pressure waves, and then magnetic waves, in an attempt to purposefully cause patterns of light. But nothing Nous or his team did seemed to produce anything useful. In Ivan Sanderson's book, Invisible Residents, an emphasis is placed on sound waves stimulating phosphorescent organisms, and is theorized that some sort of spinning machine could cause the patterns. It's even suggested that the spiraling patterns of light wheels could be caused by the song of a pair of cetaceans. Other ideas exist without needing plankton at all. Earthquake lights are a rare and poorly understood phenomenon where strange lights in the sky can sometimes be seen after intense earthquakes. Again, the ground beneath the Arabian Sea is known to be seismically active, so it's not impossible that these strange oceanic lights could be a manifestation of whatever peculiar mechanisms drive earthquake lights. But this would be difficult to prove, to say the least, and an implausible explanation for every single occurrence of the thousands of reported light wheels. Some strange variant of auroras has been suggested too, but there seems to be no reason as to why that would only happen in this ocean at this frequency it used to, or why the frequency of sightings has seemingly declined over time. It should be noted that the Indian Ocean is home to a gravitational anomaly, an area on Earth where gravity is just a little bit weaker than normal. Impossible for me to say how this would affect local earthquakes or the electromagnetic field, but it seems like the Indian Ocean is just a strange place. So far, scientific theories have failed to provide answers. So, let's turn to decidedly unscientific theories. Charles Fort, whose work is considered foundational in the fields of paranormal studies and various fringe sciences, suggested, maybe not with full sincerity, that vast wheel-like superconstructions could be responsible for many underwater light shows. He furthermore attempts to link sightings of meteors falling into the ocean with sightings of aquatic lights. Ivan Sanderson spins off this logic to suggest that entire advanced alien civilizations may exist beneath the ocean surface, evading human detection outside of what's normally written off as UFO sightings. That is a much broader topic of discussion, but as far as specific light wheels go, I do have one particular alleged UFO sighting of interest. I must confess, however, that I was unable to actually verify the story out of the singular book I found it in. So as far as the veracity of this story goes, feel free to approach this story with extra skepticism. It's a sighting reported by Czesla Kowecki as he was vacationing in the coastal Polish town of Leba. In order to have a last good look at the sea, he had decided to walk back to the hotel. He took his shoes and socks off and strolled along the sandy dunes that separated Lake Lebesco from the sea and stopped for a while on the seashore to gaze at the waters lit splendidly by the full moon. Reluctantly noticing the time by his wristwatch, he had turned to move on when a sudden noise of rushing waters made me turn towards the sea again, and right in front of me, around 300 meters from the shore, the surface was rising in one spot. It looked like a round hill, pushed up from beneath. Then, splashes of hot water gushed from the top, and like fountain jets, fell around the hole in the waves. From this opening in the water emerged an object, which at first I thought to be an elongated triangle. The object rose a few meters and hovered above the same spot, and there was now a whirlpool of water rushing inwards with a loud sucking and gurgling noise. The object itself was black and silent. Suddenly, there appeared a belt of steady white light segmented by a number of convex dark streaks. Now it became apparent that the thing had the shape of a huge funnel with two rims, separated by a belt of segmented light. Mr. Kowecki said he was certain that there was some rotating movement involved. The light now became bluish and more intense. The object moved towards the north and upwards at an angle of 45 degrees, with a speed not exceeding that of a jet. It became just a diminishing spot of light until it finally disappeared. There was no sound. There has been at least one attempt at harnessing the potential of this phenomenon for war. No, wait, sorry, I meant for art. In 2018, a group of MIT students proposed a large-scale art project directly inspired by old reports of light wheels. The hope was, in a manner very similar to Stijn Nause's experiments, ascertain the ideal frequency by which one can simulate the phosphorescence of plankton, to someday create a system wherein a tank of them could be used to create patterns and potentially even three-dimensional holographic shapes. The team thought this idea had huge potential, with hopeful plans of deploying working models into art museums and aquariums, not to mention its use in holographic displays. It seems this group was able to at least perform one successful experiment, in which a very small sample of the plankton could be stimulated into light with the right sound wave frequencies. But that was as far as the group got before the student graduated, and the project was shelved. This represents untapped scientific potential. In exploring and solving the mystery by which these strange organisms can be made to light up in patterns, a new type of volumetric display could be developed. I don't really anticipate TVs being lit by plankton in the future, but you never really know where technology will lead. So, if any marine biologists out there need some outlandish projects to start, this is still an unexplored field. I don't think I have to elaborate too much on how vast and unexplored the ocean is. The fact that 80% of it has never been seen by human or drone eyes should say leagues about what could be down there. Is it implausible that some underwater civilization remains hidden down there, glimpsed only by strange lights and fireballs? The mere fact that such huge and brilliant displays of light can be seen thousands of times, with no real explanation or source, tells us just how much there is to learn about the abyssal, untouched nation that is our Earth's ocean. If you liked this exploration of a strange mystery, you may also like my video about a mysterious body found over 100 years ago that has never been identified. I hope to see you again soon with another video. Until then, take care of yourself.